This is my secret diary of parameters to be considered before choosing a higher education institute. The last decade has shown a drastic growth in higher education institutes in the country because of the privatization of higher education. Gujarat has also witnessed the same growth by multi-folding the higher education seats in the last decade. A student passing out from the 12th grade and aspiring to take admission in a higher education institute has a lot of options today. As a result of more options, more effort has to be made to choose the correct institute. But how to find the correct institute? Most people are dependent on the word of mouth. Some are relied on social media and other advertisements. For some people, it is the highest package got the pass out students and so on. But is it really the correct way? I don't think so. Then what is the correct process? Let us see. It may seem little difficult, but it is not. What we need to identify is the correct parameters for evaluating an institute. And these days, government has done a lot of work which will ease our work. Yes, selecting the best institute goes through four processes. Explore the institutes. Check the approvals and statutory requirements. Check the rankings. And try to understand the soul of the institute. And the success lies in the fact, as early we start the process of choosing the institute is better. Because an early start will give us a lot of freedom to go through all levels of analysis. Exploration is nothing but opening your eyes. Observe the institutes around the area which are interested to you. Prepare a list, understand the infrastructure. Read in between the lines of all advertisements. Talk to the people who are already studied and find the whereabouts. Where are they? What are they doing? Here the salary package of pass out students are not the primary concern. Because a good career is built with lot of investment in terms of time and efforts. So, the initial years may not produce much profit. Statutory approval. Every institute operating in the country should have approvals from the statutory bodies. First one is University Grant Commission. Statutory organization of the Government of India for the coordination, determination and maintenance of standards of teaching, examination and research in university education. Every university in the country should have the approval of UGC. Check the same in the UGC website. If you are thinking about medical education, don't even think about an institute without having Indian Medical Association approval. All India Council for Technical Education approval is essential to conduct technical education, such as engineering management studies etc. in the country. Check the details of the institute or college in the AICTE website. The same website will give the details such as courses offered, faculty strength, intake capacity etc. If you are a student aspiring a course in pharmacy, don't forget to verify the approval of college by Pharmacy Council of India. The pharmacy education and profession in India up to graduate level is regulated by the PCI, a statutory body governed by the provisions of the Pharmacy Act. If you are aspiring to take admission in an all-time favorite nursing profession, please check the approval of the institute with Indian Nursing Council. Without the approval of INC, your degree will not be valid. If you wish to be part of the noble profession of physiotherapy, join any institute which has approval of Indian Association of Physiotherapists. Explore the rankings. There are number of rankings and accreditations conducted by state and central government to grade the university. Some of them are: National Assessment and Accreditation Council conducts assessment and accreditation of universities or other recognized institutions to derive an understanding of the quality status of the institution. It evaluates the institutions for different criteria and give grade. National Institutional Ranking Framework provides ranking to the higher education institutes in the country. It is the best parameter to compare two institutions. Similarly, Gujarat State has started ranking the institutes within the state under Gujarat State Institutional Ranking Framework. Here also most the parameters and methods of ranking is same as NIRF. But applicable only the institutes within the state. National Board of Accreditation is applicable for each program offered in an approved institute. Accreditation by NBA is an assurance of the standard of the program which meet the standards prescribed by regulatory body, which is well in line with international standard of engineering education. Even after having all the mentioned approvals and rankings, one thing which makes an education institute different is the soul of that organization. The soul, what I mean is its management and faculty. For example, if the educational institute is running as a business model and profit-oriented, it will be possible to produce the degree, but may not be a good human being. So, the ethical and human values of top management of the organization, their primary motto and standard and status of faculties and staff teaching in the organization need to be studied carefully. Which can be best done by a visit to the institute and interact with peoples around. Over and above the points mentioned, there are many more points such as affordability, location, language barriers and many more that will decide choosing the institute. But the key of correct decision is prioritizing the musts and compromising the wants. It is after all personal decisions and depend on the student and parents. So, the higher education aspirants, what are you waiting for? We have a lot of work to do. If you feel the need of any help, please don't hesitate to contact us. We will be happy to help. Don't take a chance, because the years you spend in an undergraduate institute will help you to do better in the future.